We are going to keep it lit. You know what we're going to do? This is a light we're going to keep it. We're going to take pictures. You got it.
And I always take a picture of the set.
Okay. I always take a picture of the
set.
Thank you.
Nice.
Great to meet you.
Where's your store? Wendy's.
Wendy's Old Fashioned Hamburgers, 1977.
What's the deal with the square burgers?
What's the deal with the square burgers?
That's a good question.
To make it more juicy? To keep more juice? Or
you know what? I think it was a Dave Thomas thing. I think, like, the founders of Wendy's, I think it was, like, you know, something different. It fit the patties, like, in upstate New York and in Ohio.
There's a lot of square burgers. No square burgers.
That's pretty funny.
That's a good Google. A George Foreman grill or
no,
a grill?
Grill. Whatever you get is grill.
Cool.
I have no idea what I'm doing. I made steaks a couple times. I made burgers a few times. I'm still kind of lost. What advice do you have for something like that?
Hot grill. Nice and oiled. And then you put something on, whether it's a burger, steak, lamb chop. Stop touching it. Stop turning it. Let it cook. Let it caramelize 3, 4, 5 minutes per side till it gets nice and crusty. And let it rest. When you take the meat off, let it rest 4 or 5 minutes while the juices go back in before you dig into it.
Now, are you an advocate of keeping the lid closed or open?
Well, you keep the lid closed, you're going to get some smoke and get some great smoke flavor to it. You know, you're going to also get overhead heat. Yeah? Keeping the grill open is just underneath heat with not a lot of smoke. So really, I'm a big advocate of closing it for a little while, getting some smoke, getting some overhead heat, getting some crust on it, caramelization.
You're from Chicago.
From originally upstate New York, but yes, 30 years in Chicago. Absolutely.
You ever had cooked a meal with Barack Obama?
I have, actually.
How does he like a steak?
You know, he didn't have steak. He had lamb.
Lamb.
Yeah, we ate at my kitchen table at True, him and Michelle, before he was the president, with another couple for her birthday. And we did about 12 courses, but the main course was lamb, I believe.
Now, what's the significance of the tattoos?
Well, the significance of the tattoos is it's been a life journey of 30 years. You know, post-Christian food.
We got an ad arm.
This is all food on this side. It's kind of like the story of the spoon, the fork, the knife, cheese, and the plate, the nursery rhyme. It goes up into a bunch of more food. We don't know each other well enough, so I'm not going to get all addressed for you. Yeah, to
all my tattoos.
But yeah. My Christ and my on this side, and it's just a great testimony for me of what Christ has brought me.
Nice.
Hi, guys. Good to meet you. It's all about it.